is Theo Nabicht, clarinet player from Berlin. He's a member of the KNM, Kammer Ensemble Musik, Berlin, since 20 years or something. 25 years. And he's our guest for this tonight presentation, and also he will be playing our closing concert tomorrow, where there will be a piece of Kurtajörd for two pianos and two clarinets, actually two basset horns. And we put around this piece some other pieces for two pianos or two clarinets. This was the advertisement. And now I ask Theo to start his presentation about the contrabass.
Nice that you can be at this place and play with the help of Goethe Institute. So I would like to introduce you my little diva, my contrabass clarinet. So this is a, you see a large instrument. It's a, I hear it in Hungary, it exists one time, one.
Of wood, yeah. The metal, we have two, maybe two more.
Okay. So in Germany we have a little bit more, and in Switzerland they have it in the army, so it's quite common film. But yeah, it's a very nice instrument, and many people think this is a very young instrument, but this is not true. This is an old instrument. When if we start to think about when the clarinet was born in 1756. 50 years later, the contrabass clarinet came on Earth. So, and the first composer was the Ivry. He was writing, he was the first piece for contrabass clarinet in 1806 exactly. So
when?
1806.
1806.
What's
his name?
The Ivry. He was quite famous in the 19th century, but in, we don't know. We ask the French people, French musicians, composers, they know him, but the Germans don't know him. Sorry.
No,
we don't know.
Was it an orchestra piece?
Yeah, it was an orchestra piece. Yes. So and. So and, but why we don't know this instrument so well? Because it's a French instrument. The French system and the German system were split a long time till now. And yeah, some composers gave more the bassoon, the contrabassoon,
the
four time.
The
advance? The advance, yes. So
they prefer more the bassoon or the contrabassoon?
They use more the contrabassoon. Okay, the history of my instrument is a very sad story and a very nice story. When I was studying clarinet in Strasbourg in France, and my teacher told me all the time, yes, you should play the contrabass clarinet. The name was Among There. And yes, I, as a student, you don't have so much money to buy mainly a contrabass clarinet because they are mostly expensive. So, but after a while I bought one, and so we come to this point. Now we have four models of contrabass clarinet. This is the only wood one they exist. So there are a lot of wood ones in the world, but there are also the metal one. There was a factory called Leblanc. In the 1960s, they were very famous for to make this contrabass clarinet of metal. For example, Anthony Braxton, the free jazz player, they use it a lot in their compositions. So now we have two worlds, the wood world and the metal world. So I came to this instrument because a colleague of mine from the Ensemble Moderne from Frankfurt, he was playing this instrument. And when I saw this instrument first and I listened to this instrument, I thought, oh, this is amazing. And but then he told me how much it costs, and I said, okay, next life, next something like this. But then there was a problem here. He had an accident and he died. Oh, so and after he died, there was a big competition who can get this instrument. Really, that's true. Because there was one piece by Rolf Riem, a composer from Frankfurt, from Germany. He wrote one piece for Wolfgang Spee. And so they didn't know who should play this. Yeah, and I won this competition, so the instrument comes to me. So this is very nice, but at the other side, it's very tragic, you know. And at the other side, this instrument has a big history, and I have to do something with this instrument. So it pushed me a lot to do something with the instrument and. Develop this instrument and this, in a new way. I'm looking for a new way. I'm really curious about what's inside this instrument. What can I play? So, okay, this is fun. Yeah, maybe I start to play a little bit for you. That we don't talk too much. The first solo piece I knew for contrabass clarinet was from Gérard Grisey, French composer. Yes, he was writing this piece, Anubis Mu, for Harry Spanner, one of the famous Dutch clarinet players. So.
Sorry. So this instrument is out of production, so you cannot buy a new one like that?
You can buy every year one, if you want, but the price for this is, the price in the list is 25,000 euros, but the instrument is a mistake. And if you bought this instrument by Selmer in France, you have to bring it to Switzerland. Then you have to take 10,000 euros more, and then we change the model, and then you can start to play. That means my instrument cost a little bit more than 35,000 euros. So that's how it is. It's very cheap. If you buy a violin, it's really cheap.
You think you play now the Grisey piece?
Yeah, I play now the Grisey.
Maybe we say something. Well, no. Well, maybe just to tell you, Gérard Grisey, because they probably don't know Gérard Grisey. This is, I think. Sorry, Gérard Grisey was a very important composer. Died in the 90s, and this piece called Anubis Mu. Anubis is the god of the earth or the underworld, you know, in Egypt, and Nu is god of the sky or something. Can you tell us something more about the piece before you play, or did you just play it?
I just played. first guy who makes a list of he was very interested on the changing of sound if, with the keys. That means, for example, and he wrote all the possibilities he would use. That means, for example, you hear. In the contemporary music, there are not so many compositions for contrabass done. There are some, of course, for example, Xenakis, Grisey, Schönberg. They use the contrabass done, but to find really a solo concert for contrabass done orchestra, still now it doesn't exist. Will come, but still now it's not on the way. It's on the way, but it don't exist. So I asked a lot of composers, because this instrument is for me for the clarinet, for example, there are a lot of composers who had done something for this Mozart and boom. So we know that. And for this instrument, not so many people really know how to write for this instrument. So I asked composers to work with me to develop something. So it's coming, for example, that, for example, you know this composer Marc André, is a German composer, now quite famous. He was at my place, in my studio, where I'm practicing, with my contrabass clarinet for 4 weeks, 5 days a week. And he stayed in my room around 5 hours each day. That means he wrote a piece, and then he wrote all possibilities with this instrument for himself down. It was amazing work he has done. And now I will show you the end. What? Only one page of this. It's going a little bit long. What he was writing for me. Okay. Don't be afraid. Only 2-3 minutes. this piece is called EV7. It's introvertiert 7. So, and he developed a cosmos on it. And I will tell you the story that when we made the first performance in Berlin at the Ultraschall Festival, so we were in a very old building and there was a heating, very, very loud. You can imagine what was going on. So the heating was louder than the air. So it was pretty, but yeah.
She loves you.
Already.
So of course there are many possibilities now to use instruments in totally different ways. I brought a piece by Georg Katzer. He is from Germany, he's from Berlin. He is the founder of the Studio Akademie der Künste of Electronic Art. So he was a very, very important, still very, very important person in the electroacoustic music in Berlin. So he wrote for me a piece in the beginning without a mouthpiece. So he called the piece Nemo. So. Yeah, I don't know why you are laughing. Okay. And peace go on. And this is a short experience or short examples, because you see some of the composers use the same material with the mouthpiece, without the mouthpiece. They're very interested in overtones, so yeah, this was Nemo. Another piece I would like to show you for a short moment is a quite new piece from Bernhard Gander. He's from Vienna. He wrote this piece last year for me. So he is using the instrument in a normal way. Yes, and it means he is interested in normal sounds, but he's very interested also in rhythmical things. And he works as a DJ too, so he likes a lot the hard stuff of music, yeah, hard rock. And, so Maybe I will say something to my instrument. The deepest tone is 29.4 hertz. Mm. Yes, this is the deepest. I will show it one time. I know after the presentation, mostly the people ask me, can you play a really tone?
Yes.
And the deepest, please. This is a subcontra B. This is the deepest tone we have on the contrabass clarinet. It's quite deep. And from this point, we have around 5.5 octaves up. Yes, that means if I play now, this is the fifth octave. That means. There are a lot of voices in the instrument, you can believe, because if you have such a range, it's not a piano, but a little bit smaller, so it's very nice to have this many colorful things. So let's play a little bit from Bernhard Gander. The piece is called Morbidable. Thank you. play another piece now. If you want, I can play it. For me, it's the whole. Normally, I would play this piece at the end, but the other pieces I have to play after this, they're really hard stuff. So I try to to keep the energy for myself. So the, of course, if you have such a nice instrument with so many colors, you start to practice on it, and you try to find something new or something in the instrument, and you didn't know it. So, and so I start to develop a series of compositions where I escape something for this instrument. I wrote a piece, it's called Zahlen, die stillstehen, irgendwann in einem fernen, gewöhnlichen Sommer. For people who know Inga Christensen, it's a pleasure to hear this because it's from the alphabet. And I was really inspired by her poems. I like her clear sound and her voice. It's fantastic. So, and for her, I wrote this piece. the name I told you, I told already, it's Rolf. He wrote a piece for me, it's called Ton für Ton, Weiße Straßen von Babylon.
The
story about this piece is he was on an airplane and there was Iraq the war. And he was going with his wife from Germany to India. And then he, in one moment, he looked out of the window of the airplane and he saw the old streets from Mesopotamia. Yes, our history, our cultural start point. Yes. So and at the other side, he realized now there's a big war. So he had to write a piece. And of course, the piece is not nice, for sure. Sorry. I'm not a man musician who feel that words or notes, tones, sounds can say anything because they are only sounds. But often we tell stories to bring the people to one point. But mostly I feel it's wrong because it's only music. You understand? So I'm gespalten.
Divided.
Yeah, I feel divided because in one point I want to say something, of course, because that's why I'm on stage. On the other side, I say these are not words, and so it's for me difficult. But
you don't have to say something about life. You can say something about the music. Like for example, the first part starts very high. This is something
but
you can say, but
can hear it. I, it's not necessary to say
it. For some people, if they think of it, then they hear it better sometimes. Let's check.
Yeah. I don't play the whole piece because it goes more than 20 minutes. So maybe I play one part, it's in six parts. I play one part and then I go a little bit forward so you get an idea. What he was writing. So this piece is really for me the hard stuff because it goes over 5.5 octaves, and to get the high G6, it's the highest tone in this piece, it took me 1 year to get the sound. So it's quite discovering something new. But I think the sound in very high notes are very nice, and I love to play this high, so it's beautiful for me, for myself, so I'm going on at this. So the last piece I would introduce you, yes, I don't play the piece, the whole piece too, because it goes 25 minutes. So it's from Iris Tashipov. She's a composer from Berlin. She's living now in Vienna and has their professor. So she was she goes in the same direction as Rolf Riem. She in this work she titled as Orpheus 2014. Die Aufgabe von Musik,
the duty, the role of
the role. Thanks a lot. The role of music. So, and she started to think a lot about this, and has music meaning? Can the sound say something to us? Can why it helps our soul? And she combined it with political themes, so it's for me a very interesting person. So I think before I play this, any questions about my instrument, about something? Please be invited to say something or not.
I have a question.
Yes, please.
How long can you play this instrument continuously? Because I guess it's much more tiring than playing a normal clarinet.
Yes. When I had this instrument the first month, after half an hour I had to go to bed. It's really true. So, and I have to make a lot of sports to get the energy. And you see, I'm sweating from only a little bit playing. So it's continuously, of course, I can play half an hour without break, no problem. But if I have to play very loud, it's get tired.
Yeah.
So it's a big problem. So it's a real instrument, yes.
Müssen Sie auch immer während dem Stehen spielen?
No. He asked if I have to stand up all the time for playing. For me, it's very nice because the body is free, and I like to play in a standing position. So, but of course, in the orchestra, if I play, for example, Grisey, Espace Acoustique, I can't stay up because the solist is there. Yeah.
No more questions?
Okay. Then I will say thank you for coming. So, and it was a pleasure for me to speak a little bit to you and introduce my big project. So.